congregation please rise?
Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you.
divided and its way by sin, may be free and brought together under his most gracious rule, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God now and forever.
Today, along with the Catholics, Lutherans, Presbyterians, and Methodists, we celebrate the Feast of Christ the King, the last Sunday of the liturgical year. Scripture refers to Jesus as King, King Eternal, King of Israel, King of the Jews, King of Kings, and Ruler of the Earth. What in fact does it mean to say that Jesus is King? How important is it that he is both fully human and fully divine? And how central is the resurrection to understanding of Jesus as King? And moving beyond this purely academic conversation here, how does this matter in the midst of our lives, the moments of our hours, when we hear this scripture? What does it mean not only to claim, but to actually confess that Jesus is King? We put a lot of things in our lives that we consider important at the top of our list. These things that are the end-all, be-all in our lives. But what if we put Christ at the top of that list? Consider this. Think of a gift. You know what I'm talking about. That one thing that you have on your eyes for Christmas. Maybe you point it out when you walk by the store or show it to people online. You want it. You need it. If you don't get it, it will be like part of you has been buried in a hole of sadness so much, though, that any other gift you get for Christmas will not matter. And then if you do get it, about a week later, the next it thing comes by, and the love for that precious gift that you had and needed is gone. The new and better thing has now come in and is on top of your list, and it consumes your life. Do you remember what you wanted for Christmas so badly 3 years ago? Not last year, or 2 years ago. What was that one thing you wanted for Christmas 3 years ago? What was on the top of your list? I don't remember either. You see, we get so embroiled in what we want, so focused on the latest, the next hot item of the Christmas season, that there is always going to be a newer, shinier, more advanced model to hope for, to need to survive, to get through the day. But let's face it, by Christmas, by New Year's, the packages will be gone, the greens will be falling all over the floor, and the Christmas tree will look empty and sort of resemble Charlie Brown's. The frenetic pace that ramps us up to Christmas will be fading away, and our lives will return to normal. But things for us cannot turn back to normal. You see, we've been given this gift that has been remembered for more than 3 years, for actually thousands of years. We've been given the gift of keratos, this gift of truth, something undeserved, given out of love. We've been given Christ. And not only that, this gift was given in out of total humility and grace for everyone. Christ showed us what it means to be King of Kings, to fully lay out on the table and know the consequences. In today's gospel, Pilate asked Jesus if he is a king. And this is the beginning to a lot of questions. In verse 38, which is not part of today's reading, he asks a much deeper religious question. What is truth? Jesus says that indeed, he is a king, but not of this world. We will not make the mistake of thinking that he's a mere king in heaven floating around on a cloud smiling. Jesus compares being a king to testifying to the truth. Jesus is not the king of lies, trickery, or mere appearances. His kingdom is not of this world. He's the king of truth, reality, spirit, and sacredness. That's his world. But both these worlds exist here on earth. Indeed, Jesus' kingdom is not of this world. The question for all of us is, as we go through our lives, what world do we live in? Who will be our king? Who will be the pilot of our age? Or Jesus? Do we know the questions? Even from the beginning with Adam and Eve, humanity has had the choice. We were given knowledge. We can choose to follow our Lord, our King. We can choose to put other things in front of Christ, like the newest iPod or Wii U. With our King, there's no one to put us to death for not swearing allegiance to. It's our choice. If we put Christ as King in our lives truly at the top, what would Christmas look like? What would our daily lives look like? Would we give more of ourselves? Would we go out and serve? How can you bring a kingdom here on earth this Advent and proclaim Christ as King? Amen.
Who we now name. name, either silently or aloud. We pray for the departed, praying especially for Joanna, Alvin, Bernie, and Francis. We offer thanksgiving for the generosity of those pledging to the annual stewardship campaign, for the birthdays of Sherry, Rita, and Betty, and for Tyler, and Anthony, sponsored for ordination by this parish.
Lord Jesus Christ, you say to your apostles, peace I give to you, my own peace I leave with you. Regard not our sins, but the faith of your church, and give to us the peace and unity of that heavenly city, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign, now and forever. Amen. Ascribe to the Lord the honor due his name. Bring offerings and come into his courts.
Thank you.
Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because in Jesus Christ our Lord, you have received us as your sons and daughters, made us citizens of your kingdom, and given us the Holy Spirit to guide us into all truth. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. our Lord Jesus Christ, equip you